We're tracking Hurricane Erin this morning as it is now at Category 4, but it is picking up some strength this morning. Good morning, Gulf Coast. Thank you for joining us here on your Saturday morning. I'm Mercedes Martinez.
And I'm Samantha Romero. So Caroline Castro, she's been tracking this major hurricane here. So Caroline, it's only getting stronger.
Yes, it is. This morning, it's been very busy, and I mentioned a couple minutes ago that I was telling you that I wouldn't be surprised if it made a run for that Category 5 strength with the most recent update. Well, the most recent update just came out. They held it just below Cat 5 strength, but they bumped up the intensity forecast down the line, and it does have it becoming a Category 5 storm later on today. So yesterday it was still a tropical storm. It became a Category 1 hurricane last night. So the fact that it made such a jump, such rapid intensification is very, very interesting. With this overall track for the storm, you can see those fives added on. You never like to see that. However, the track, once again, is best case scenario because it it over open water. Yes, places like Puerto Rico will still see some heavy rain from this, some gusty winds as well, but they should stay away from the worst of Hurricane Erin, and so should the Bahamas and a bunch of other islands out there in the Atlantic. Bermuda's one to watch, though, because it is further into the future and into the cone of uncertainty, but they have time, and it does have it outside of Bermuda at this point. But I was waiting for this update, because this update, they bumped those wind speeds up to 155 miles per hour. The pressure, 923 millibars with this update. It just continues to bomb out. It continues to intensify. That pressure continues to deepen, which means that it's getting stronger. So yes, it's set to make that Category 5 strength later on today. But what does that look like? Well, Category 5 is wind speeds greater than 156 miles per hour. But remember, I just said the wind speeds are 155 miles per hour. So we're right on the cusp already. And those hurricane hunters are going to continue to investigate this storm. Give us the vital information needed to tell us how strong it actually is. But for the first hurricane of the 2025 season in the Atlantic, Erin is certainly trying to make a mark, but in a way that luckily isn't too impactful to land or any islands or anything like that, not set to hit the U.S. either. So that is good news. And here's what that track looks like. I will say there's a little more uncertainty with where Erin's going to go, and that's expected when it rapidly intensifies. But it's not a crazy spaghetti model either, where there's still good consensus over the next few days, and then that's when it starts to spread out. Luckily, that outlier does have it going a little bit further east, which could mean more problems for places like Bermuda, but also it doesn't look like it's the norm at this time. Something for us to pay attention to, for sure. Something that meteorologists are going to be watching. Remember, though, since it curves back out into the Atlantic, the only impacts for the eastern U.S. would be in the form of rough surf conditions as well as rip currents, too, that they'll have to worry about there.